Sean T. Scary, Fracalosi Workman with rights. Dowdell and Gordon, the senior backcourt, along with Washington Collins, who was 17 when he enrolled at Virginia Tech. And the Dutch 7-foot sophomore center, Robert Krabbendam. This telecast available on ESPN2 HD, presented by Olivia. Not a long history between these two schools, but what games have taken place have all gone to the Broncos, all four. Last meeting December 22nd of 04, a 6-point win for Western Michigan. The only previous neutral site game came in 1976 at South Bend. That was a first-round NCAA tournament game. And it went to overtime before Western Michigan prevailed 77-67. Steve Hawkins, fourth-year head coach of the Broncos, three straight 20-win seasons, 03 through 05, and the last year fell off to 14-17, although a winning record in the MAC, 10-8. And Seth Greenberg, also in his fourth year, head coach of the Hokies, 14-16 last year. But before that, the ACC coach of the year. Virginia Tech, one of the new additions to the ACC. The Hokies controlled the tap, and Jamon Gordon will walk it up.
Man-to-man for Western Michigan. Virginia Tech, a lot of set plays in their offense.
Hokies are 2-0. Broncos are 1-2. Coming off a win over Detroit by two. And the first points belong inside to Virginia Tech.
Right off the bat, a little bit of pressure by Virginia Tech. They'll change their defenses throughout the night. Zone, man, and presses.
Jamon Gordon averaging 10.5 points per game. And here are the Broncos, and right away Gary likes what he sees straight on. He is 3 for 3 this young season from three.
Only a sophomore, and he has improved his outside shooting because last year 10 for 45 behind the arc. Worked on it this summer.
Ball tipped away from Dowdell, but traveling is the call against Fracalosi.
Young Western Michigan team, no seniors.
But more experience, Fran, than they had last year, even with some seniors, as Washington almost gets a 3-point opportunity, fouled by Xavier Dowdell.
That's a good point. They finished, as you mentioned, 14-16, but were red hot down the stretch of that MAC race, won 10 of their last 15.
Ended up in the tournament quarterfinals falling. Washington 7 for 11 at the line this year, off to a good start. 12 and 18 points in the first two Virginia Tech games, both wins.
And this is a guy last year, Dave, had to play a lot of power forward in the ACC. Krabbendam was out. He gets to play on the perimeter this season.
Son of a long time NFL star, Lionel Washington, now an assistant with the Green Bay Packers.
Keep your eye now on that pressure by Tech and see how Western Michigan attacks.
Well, that's the way they'd like to, although they want Gary to get a shot off. Dowdell hurries and beats everybody down the floor. He needs Washington's tip-in.
Saw the athleticism on the backboard. And this game is right up Tech's alley in terms of the pace early.
Riddell saw Gordon leave the lane and left him either a layup or free throws, as turned out to be the case.
Well, Western Michigan with a good job versus pressure. They get it down the floor. Gary loses it, and then Hokies off to the races. Washington cleans up the miss.
Riddell fouled by Deron Washington. Neither of these two teams exactly specialize in free throw shooting. We're really early, but there are really ugly free throw shooting numbers on both sides. Riddell gets help from the back of the rim. Western Michigan shooting to 62% from the line as a team. Virginia Tech would take that. They're 56%. Even if you are just two games in, that's horrible.
And especially when you've blown two teams out. There's Gordon. This backcourt of Gordon and Dowdell, they're like mirror images of each other. Gordon the lefty, Dowdell the righty.
Rob and Dom popping out to get the ball out of Riddell's hands. And the three-pointer would not go for Workman. So here come the Hokies. Leading 7-5. Labadon travels. Didn't play last year, recovering from knee surgery. Signed as a 7-foot, 195 pounder out of Hoorn, the Netherlands.
Still more of a finesse player than I think the Virginia Tech coaching staff would like, but only a sophomore.
Western Michigan, first time they go inside. Wrights has it stripped away by Xavier Dowdell. And as they try to run, they turn it over.
Well, Dowdell had two players running through that passing lane. Not sure anybody knew who that was for, but you get a good example. Two Florida guys, Dave, so they're home. They're excited about that. And these guys started in the Big East as freshmen, remember, and then the last 3 years in the ACC.
Gary had a step on Gordon, knifed in past Krabbendam, and he ends up starting the fast break. Dowdell from Pahokee, Florida, 6'3 senior. Gordon, as you said, also from Florida. He's from Jacksonville.
Thing about these guards is neither is a pure point or a pure two. They're both combo guards. It's like an old-fashioned backcourt.
Yeah, believe it or not, there was a time in basketball where you just had two guards and you just had two forwards.
Yep.
There was no point or shooting guard. There was no small or power forward. Three on the shot clock.
And Gordon
did a good job
acting like he had no idea the shot clock was about to wind up at zero. He's got seven.
I think he froze the defender because he sort of took his time. Didn't have a sense of urgency.
Just his second three of the year. And 10-5 for the Hokies. Western Michigan having a hard time getting any decent looks. Workman misses. Wrights is fouled. No, travels before contact.
Well, keep your eye now on Gordon, just taking his time. He's just effortlessly almost lulled Wrights to sleep. Got a good look at it. Here's another look. Clock running down.
You know what? If this were the end of the game, I'm not sure that wouldn't be reviewed.
I know it.
I mean, he used every last tenth of a second. Virginia Tech going to the bench. Their leading scorer, 20.5 points per game. A.D. Basayo, a 6'6 sophomore from Puerto Rico.
More impressive. How about in 17 minutes a game in those two games?
Wasting no time. And he is guarded by Derek Drews, a 6'5 sophomore, who comes in off Steve Hawkins' bench.
Steve Hawkins' young team, he does have depth, and he'll play a lot of guys. Look at that.
Right to work, Masayo. And the tip by Collins wouldn't go. Broncos with numbers. First time handling it, Andrew Hirschberger. Junior from Goshen, Indiana. That's a degree.
Well, he's a young man that's got 30 starts under his belt, coming off the bench right now. Experienced player.
Good look inside, and Collins is fouled by Hirschberger.
Impressive pass by Versailles. Here's a guy that scores the basketball, but the presence of mind to find Collins underneath. Great look inside.
When we come back, Collins goes for a three-point play and a six-point Hokie lead.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Old Spice Deep Cleansing Body Wash. Nothing cleans deeper. And The Q, the heat-activated oil that helps maximize the power of your engine. Unleash all your horses.
Back inside the Milk House at Walt Disney World. The Old Spice Classic quarterfinal led early 12-7 by Virginia Tech. Virginia Tech with an extremely challenging year a year ago. One thing after another happened to him, including Alan Callaway, a senior, diagnosed with cancer just before practice began. Ended up losing over 30 pounds over the course of the season. Coleman Collins lost his father to cancer. Dron Washington's mother had her house destroyed by Hurricane Katrina, moved from New Orleans to Blacksburg, Virginia. On and on and on. Mm-hmm.
And it really carried over to the court. 4-12 in the ACC. And 8 of their last 10 losses by 4 points or less. And, you know, the philosopher Nietzsche said that which doesn't kill you makes you stronger. And this is a very tough basketball team. It's one of the reasons I like them so much. They've been through adversity. They have a lot of experience back, both on and off the court.
Nietzsche's correct. They should be one of the strongest teams in the history of college basketball after all that last year. Joe Wright's inside his first two.
Wright's is a guy that jumps. He can't barely get over the Orlando Sentinel Sunday newspaper, but knows how to use his body and gets to the foul line with regularity.
MAC Player of the Year candidate. Makes it 13-9. And a hold is the call against Derrick Drews, his first and the team's second.
Boy, Vasayo plays at warp speed. Keep your eye on Joe Wright's now. And watch him use his body. Now, he's not going to jump over the defender. Diakite puts his hand straight up, but Wright's just a little bump to throw him off.
Numbers from last year for Wright, second team All-MAC, academic All-MAC.
Coaches I talked to in the MAC this summer, everybody double teams him.
Broncos get a steal. Andre Ricks, Hirschberger, and now Drews launches the three-pointer. He is nailing that shot this year, 9-for-12 beyond the arc.
Came in with a great reputation at Elkhart Central. So many of these kids within an hour or so of the Kalamazoo campus.
Missing on the drive was Nigel Munson.
Well, keep your eye now. Drews, former Indiana All-Star. That's pretty prestigious. Hirschberger with the kick out. Good rhythm shot. I think if you come from Indiana, it's sort of your birthright to have a deep jump shot.
Look at you strange if you can't hit 20 feet out. Derrick Drews had a 4-for-4 game on three-pointers against Pitt already this year, and he hit his first here tonight. Ricks trying to decide what to do with Munson.
Good kick out.
And another three-point try, no good by Andrew Hirschberger. As he tried to shoot the Broncos into the lead. Munson with Lewis Witcher. Vasayo all off the bench. This is Shek Jakite from Bamako, Mali.
He just doubled his average, his scoring average from a year ago with that basket. Energy guy, active inside.
Ricks just got that one over Vasayo. He drops it through.
Thing I love about this Western Michigan team, I talked to Steve Hawkins about this. Kalamazoo located in a perfect part of the state of Michigan, 2 hours from Detroit, 2 from Chicago, northern Indiana right nearby.
Scouting crossroads. One-handed rebound by Hirschberger. Off to this by Gordon. Ricks looking like the quickest man on the floor. Way short, Martell McLemore. Just in off the bench. Feast Week, presented by Lowe's, continues tomorrow night. More college basketball action on ESPN and ESPN2. Two games from the Dick's Sporting Goods NIT season tip-off. First, 4:30 Eastern, ESPN has Tennessee, North Carolina in the consolation game. And then at 7 Eastern on ESPN2.
Butler against Gonzaga in the championship game.
Somehow that sounds strange,
yes,
saying
it does.
That. But
we didn't get that reversed. No. It is Butler Gonzaga championship Tennessee North Carolina consolation.
Well, Gonzaga continues to grow into a national program. Not that they haven't been the last 3 or 4 years, but the pipeline of recruits continues.
Andre Ricks with the third team foul as Witcher checks out, replaced by Chris Tucker.
I think you're going to be a busy guy tonight, Dave, the way that scorers table has been active.
Off balance, Deron Washington, who just came in off his first rest. He gets 17-14.
Always like to score off set plays on the inbounds. It's sort of like special teams in football.
Ricks has it stripped away. Nice shot by Jamon Gordon going to the deck to come up with the steal. And now Dowdell shows that extra burst and goes around McLemore, drawing the foul.
We talked about earlier, Gordon, Dowdell, both of them handle the ball equally effectively. Dowdell, the little better shooter. Gordon, more of a creator, but both outstanding defensively.
Washington, the junior from New Orleans. Down to the baseline in traffic. Not quite for Dowdell. Tucker tried to keep it live, but it may have started a Western Michigan fast break. McLemore being told to get it back into the set play. Just past 8 minutes into this quarterfinal matchup. Offensive foul. Andre Ricks whistled for his second. A three-pointer by Derek Cruz helping Western Michigan stay close. 17-14 Hokies. Back inside the Milk House, we're at 17-14 Virginia Tech in this Old Spice Classic quarterfinal in Orlando. One of the early matchups of note nationally. Number one and number 12 on the agenda. Just the fourth meeting ever between Florida and Kansas. Jayhawks have taken two of the first three. Returning starters, both sides, all five from last year.
That will be a defend your manhood game for Kansas, who got beat by Oral Roberts earlier this season.
Chris Tucker, former walk-on from Fincastle, Virginia, with his first two.
We talked about the depth Seth Greenberg has now that he's got people healthy. He's got some freshmen out there in the rotation, a deeper team than they've had in his 3 years.
Had three seniors total his first 3 years. They've got five this year. Not sure what to do with that embarrassment of riches in terms of experience, because he has never had it here in Blacksburg. Five on the shot clock. Riddell shot blocked by Gordon. What a save by Collins. Terrifically athletic play, and then Washington fouled as he loses his footing across the paint.
Caught a break. It looked like he was about to slip, and actually he should have kicked that ball out one dribble earlier to the open Dowdell. But Washington, a guy that loves to get to the rim.
Foul called on David Cool, who is seeing his first action for Western Michigan back from a hamstring injury, and Washington's second trip to the line.
Much anticipated first action.
Yep. Michigan's Mr. Basketball Award winner coming out of Grand Rapids.
Yep, suffered a knee injury in the spring of his junior year. A lot of schools backed off him, and Steve Hawkins did not. He averaged 30 points a game as a senior and just an outstanding scorer.
Led the state of Michigan in scoring. And they're on Washington with seven, along with Gordon leading Virginia Tech scoring. They open up a 7-point lead. Here's Cool. Stripped but fouled as Xavier Dowdell tried to surprise him from behind. His second.
Cool's got to realize when there's two white shirts ahead of you, that means there's three behind chasing you. Nice job by Western Michigan of attacking that pressure early. Really like Riddell, transfer from Cleveland State. Knows how to run a team, at least early in the game. He shows that capacity.
Biggest lead of the game, Hokies by seven. Here's Riddell. Huge height disadvantage against the 6'7 Washington out front. Cool. Looks inside for Rice, who's had a quiet first half. Turned away again. Gonna need more from him, Fran. He's 14 points, about 8 rebounds per game. He's at 2 points right now.
And Virginia Tech has not had to double team him so far, which puts pressure on the perimeter of the Broncos.
Dowdell rattles in the 12-footer, his first point.
You see the strength of Dowdell to get to the middle of the lane and just elevate over the defender.
And the lead grows to 9 halfway through this first half. A little bump out front will be called on Gordon, his first in the team's fourth.
Watch Wrights now as he catches the ball inside on Collins, who doesn't really give him an angle to get to the rim. Good defense by the senior. Good position defense, didn't go for the block, made Wrights take the tough shot.
Western Michigan down 9, star for offense, they call time.
Okay. Okay.
Virginia Tech with an 8-0 run over the last 2 minutes and 47 seconds. So they lead by 9 here at the Milk House in Orlando. Dave Barnett, Fran Fraschilla, part of the Old Spice Classic, Feast Week presented by Lowe's. Under the radar teams, Virginia Tech, one of this group of four.
Well, and Air Force certainly is not under the radar any longer after the performance in Kansas City, giving Duke a run and beating Texas Tech. Watch out for Fresno State. Quinton Hosley, Javon Coleman. Got a young man named Dominic McGuire. Missouri State, everybody talks about Southern Illinois, Wichita State, Creighton, rightfully so. Barry Henson has most of that team back from a year ago.
Riddell has to adjust as Coleman Collins made that shot go a lot higher than Riddell would normally want to shoot it. Dowdell, no on the three-pointer. Western Michigan needing points.
First time they get Cool into the lineup. He feeds Wright, and Wright draws foul number 5 against the Hokies.
And that's what Wright does. He gets himself to the foul line, and mentioned 211 times last year. The key for Western Michigan right now is to establish Wright's inside, because when you don't have to double team him, Dave, then the perimeter players of Western Michigan who can shoot it, obviously, Dawes, Cool, and the like, don't have the freedom that they would if a second defender were guarding Wright's inside.
This is key also for Virginia Tech. This is the first trip to the line for Wrights, who last year in Western Michigan's history was second all-time in single-season free throw attempts and third in free throws made.
Yep.
Gordon and Washington Alvisayo returns along with Nigel Munson.
You think of 211, they played 30 games, so that's 7 free throws a game, and that's workmanlike.
So Wright ends the run of 8 unanswered Hokie points. Baseline drive. Workman tipped it out, unable to save it. Virginia Tech has yet to be challenged. They have opened with blowout wins over Coppin State, 94-43, and Western Florida, 95-47, Western Florida Division II school.
Well, they have a great non-conference schedule this year because they play about 5 or 6 neutral site games, and on the RPI, they count as road games. Seton Hall and Madison Square Garden.
Robin Dom saves his own miss, but it goes to Riddell.
So you can't call timeout now if you're an airborne player, and that leads to this break.
Wrights fumbles it away. What do you think of that rule change? Do you like the rules committee going against that, what had become such a popular move, calling timeout in midair before falling out of bounds?
I didn't like it early. You see, Krabendam can't call timeout if he's airborne. That leads to the break. But the way the officials have adjudicated that rule early, I do like it. I was not in favor of it. Didn't think you should mess with the game. At some point, someone's going to save a ball off someone's head. You may have a problem there.
Offensive foul, A.D. Vasayo with his first.
I mentioned he plays at warp speed. He really, you know, as good a scorer as he is, he doesn't let the game come to him, but that's why he's coming off the bench to give Seth Greenberg that Red Bull energy lift, I guess.
This is the first of our nighttime doubleheader. Arkansas in overtime early today over Southern Illinois, Marist over Minnesota. Dave Barnett and Fran Fraschilla. Western Michigan trailing throughout by as many as 9 by 8 here against Virginia Tech. This matchup followed about a half hour after our conclusion by West Virginia and Montana tonight.
Good solid position defense. Drive baseline. Krabendam holds his ground. Gary, a young guy from Elkhart Concord High School, home of one Sean Kemp. Back in the mid-80s.
Vasayo, count it. Gary fouls him as that hair trigger jumper goes.
Red Bull, maybe that nickname will stick.
Might be apropos.
He's one of those guys that sometimes when he's not knocking down shots will keep both teams in the game, but he also, he has that quick trigger, can score inside, and that is just just a good looking shot.
No 4-point play though. Out of bounds and touched last by Western Michigan.
Vasayo, interestingly, signed with Richmond when they made a coaching change. The University of Richmond let him out of his letter of intent. Seth Greenberg picked him up. Played a lot last year as a freshman.
Inbounds. Gordon turned away inside, and now it goes out to Western Michigan.
Another good look off the inbounds play. Didn't score that time, but you can tell sometimes when a team is well coached by how they attack those special situations.
Broncos 1-2. They win 69-67 in their home opener against Detroit. And another timeout at 7:54 remaining in the first half. All Hokies so far, they lead by 11.
Hope you've enjoyed your Thanksgiving. Virginia Tech's really enjoying it so far. They had an 8-0 run, open up a big lead. It's the biggest it's been yet. 11-26-15 over Western Michigan. Seth Greenberg ably assisted by his brother Brad.
How about that? Former general manager of the Philadelphia 76ers. Both of these guys, longtime five-star camp guys. Howard Garfinkel somewhere right now is smiling. Campers, coaches at the camp. Nice help to have the experience of your brother, who's got both NBA and college experience. Right to the right here, that happens to be Ryan Odom, who is the son of Dave Odom. So a lot of basketball heritage right there.
A couple of dynasties running the show over there for Virginia Tech. As Wright says, both free throws.
Although Dave Odom does not want to defend that NIT title again after two consecutive championships, I can guarantee you.
Coleman Collins won't get a better look. Dracolosi pulls down the board. Walk on from Davison, Michigan. 7.5 minutes first half. Western Michigan offense starved so far. This 5 of 14 from the field, so they go to their bell cow and Wrights after a very slow start, now with 7.
You don't mind that if you're Seth Greenberg, because he really had to work for that shot. Wrights needs to kick it out some as well, get those three-point shooters some good looks as well.
Ricks gambled for the steal. That leaves the open shot for Munson. Andrew Hershberger pulls down the board.
These guys really attack the glass, Western Michigan.
Open look at a three. Workman misses everything, and badly. Here comes Vasayo. Red Bull. I think we got his nickname.
There we go.
And this could have been an offensive foul on him. In fact, it is his second.
You mean Red Bull in a China shop.
Exactly.
Look at this. There is no way he's giving up the rock, fellas. No way. Nice job right here. Now watch Wrights. He has to really work for this. It's not really a triple team. They're just hanging around down there. So he gets a good look over Krabbendam, but well earned by Wrights.
Hokies go to trapping the ball now. And again, Wrights.
There it is, the kick out.
Wrights setting up a wide open three, which Fracolosi couldn't put down. McLemore turned away inside.
It's a bad empty possession right there, point blank.
Good look at a three, couple of good looks inside, and they got nothing out of it. Gordon looking to pass, it looked like, and then at the last instant decided to shoot.
That ball went in because when he released it, he shot it very softly. So it didn't kick off the rim hard.
Good start, 9 points for Gordon. Fumbled out of bounds. Now, watch the eyes here of Vasayo. Does he ever even look at the basket?
Nope. He's coming. Hold on.
Now he's looking for a soft spot to land.
Hey, I got to give Rick's credit, because Rick's life passed before his eyes. He said, Rick said, he's not stopping. He is not stopping.
Well, he's stopping now.
Yeah. How about that? Wayne Chapman scouting for the Denver Nuggets. Of course, his son Rex, now a big part of that organization. Former coach at Kentucky Wesleyan, where he had a Division II dynasty.
Looks like he could be the oldest Greenberg brother.
Mm-hmm. Well, you could throw Steve Hawkins in there too then.
Washington, I don't think meant to go glass that time. Good block from behind. Donald Lawson, 6'9 freshman from Chicago. An immediate impact off the bench. Riddell is returned. Daldell knocks it out.
Now you mentioned Dikete, not a score inside. You see the block from behind. It's a tough Western Michigan group. Five juniors, five sophomores, four freshmen.
No seniors, though.
Mm-hmm.
Steve Hawkins, fourth year. Off of 14 and 17, 05-06. Much better at the end than they were at the beginning. Hershberger again. Virginia Tech forces the adjustment. A shot that ends up higher than it was intended to be.
Good point, Dave. Little bigger front line than they'll see come January and February.
Offensive foul. Virginia Tech gives it right back. As Shek Jakite picks up his first.
A guy like that should never commit an offensive foul. He's not really an offensive player to begin with. He only really should shoot it when he grabs offensive rebound putbacks or can drop step to the rim. But it's not going to kill you with post moves.
They're not going to run a play for him.
That's right.
Not all season.
Mm-hmm.
If you're going to make contact, be going for a steal or a rebound. Washington like goes Washington. For the steal. Oh, the breakaway, and he missed it off the back rim.
That's a deflator sometimes.
And wanted a walk, but Riddell kept that pivot foot.
Whoa.
Hershberger, unable to get Collins up off his feet, scores anyway.
Well, and I like what Collins did. He's not going to get himself in foul trouble by staying on the ground. You're just going to make Hershberger make a tough shot.
Collins missing everything inside. Broncos maybe get some energy off that missed breakaway by Washington. Could be a deflator for Virginia Tech, or not. Dowdell draws the blocking foul by Riddell.
Well, the. Oh, you hate this as a coach. Washington with the breakaway.
He may hear about that all season from his teammates.
Big day for Arkansas fans tomorrow because they've got basketball in the morning and then they've got their football team trying to make it to national championship matchup with Ohio State. But first they've got to get by LSU and then win the SEC championship game.
We get that young man McFadden, who is one of the three finalists for the Doak Walker Award. I know an award near and dear to our hearts living in the Dallas Metroplex.
Man, I think ought to be right there for the Heisman, too. Mm-hmm. I haven't seen him tackle all year.
Well, I'll tell you what, West Virginia, Steve Slayton's pretty good, too.
Right and, there with him.
Yep.
Sabian Dowdell with both free throws. Virginia Tech by nine.
Well, one assist, 10 turnovers for Western Michigan in this game. Good defense by the Hokies.
And Western Michigan, Fran, just not quite quick enough to get past any of the Virginia Tech defenders.
No,
they see the openings, they can't do anything about it.
That's right. And when you don't make a second defender guard you, your teammates are not going to get open shots. A postman inside needs to be double teamed. And a guard on the perimeter, if you can get into that gap, draw the second defender and kick out, that's where you get the open shots. And they have not come by those very easily in the first half.
Riddell does draw contact from Nigel Munson here, his first team's 10th double bonus both ways.
By the way, Tommy Brennan called me earlier today to tell me that Seth Greenberg had had a speaking engagement for him set up in Blacksburg, but never sent the plane.
Whoops.
He wanted me to tell him he's still waiting for the private plane to come get him. And of course, I told Seth before the game, and he went, yeah, you know, too bad, Tom.
Sure, just an oversight.
Just an oversight. He forgot. A lot of things on his mind.
Broncos within seven. Dowdell.
Nice. He's got that step back jumper down.
Second leading active scorer in the ACC coming into this tournament. 1,226 points at six tonight.
Coleman and Gordon will go over 1,000 early this season as well. 3,000 point scores.
Rice steps through Witcher and Coleman, and Coleman Collins called for his second. Feast Week presented by Lowe's continues tomorrow night. More college hoops, ESPN and ESPN2 with two games from the Dick's Sporting Goods and IT season tip-off. 4:30 Eastern, ESPN has number 21 Tennessee against number 2 North Carolina in the consolation game, followed at 7 Eastern by Butler and number 23 Gonzaga for the championship.
Well, and how about Barry Collier back at Butler as the athletic director? He's done already a marvelous job in just a couple months. But in point of fact, Todd Licklider's got a very good basketball team.
Wright scoring at the line.
Collier, the former coach at Nebraska and very successful coach at Butler.
Under the 3 minute mark, first half.
A lot of NBA people here to see Coleman Collins tonight. He's been pretty quiet.
Went to the bench after that second foul. Marcus Sales checking in for Virginia Tech. Broncos get a stop. Pretty big possession here. And again, they draw contact by Munson.
Well, you see the ACC. Certainly four teams ranked. Maryland off to a great start. But watch out for Georgia Tech, who played very well in Maui with the young basketball team. I think the Techs are the story of the ACC, at least once you get past Carolina and Duke.
Riddell has made all five of his free throws.
Interesting, Dave, when you see some of the upsets early in the year, if you want to call them upsets, it's usually a veteran team. Sometimes at that mid-major level, beating a team like Carolina, like Kansas, with talented young players. And that's why I think Virginia Tech's going to be very solid in that league. A lot of experience back.
Michael Riddell now 6 for 6. Sophomore from Rockford, Michigan, to replace the max assist leader, Brian Snyder. The transfer from Cleveland State, and the Broncos have cut the lead down to 6.
Now 400 career assists by Snyder. That's pretty darn good passing.
Sales now in the backcourt, along with Jamon Gordon. And the big Dutchman, Krabbendam, whose pass is knocked out of bounds by Derek Drews. 12 on the shot clock.
Tried to get him involved in the pick and roll.
Witcher checking out. Chris Tucker in for the Hokies. And they have played just about everybody. They've gone 11 deep here in the first half. I think Western Michigan's probably matching him man for man, sub for sub. Dowdell stays outside, misses the three. Rebound tipped over to Gordon, though, and they get a fresh shot clock as we go under 2 minutes and a half.
Well, even Sales in the game now has had a lot of starting experience for Seth Greenberg.
Seth with 5 seniors, more than he had in his first 3 years combined. He averaged 1 senior per year.
until this year. Gordon stops, hits the 17-footer.
Really nice pull-up. He plays it with a good pace to his game. Sometimes when you're not super quick, it actually is to your benefit because you kind of pick and choose your spots. You don't play too fast, which can happen.
Riddell's pass deflected. So here's Gordon, 11 points, and he may be the top defensive guard in the ACC.
You know, I'm just thinking the same thing. Both of these guards, Dowdell and Gordon, all ACC defensive team, voted by the coaches. So that tells you something about the respect they have.
Riddell for the three in his first basket. Now 4 for 9 for the year beyond three. The Broncos have made some progress now as they chop the lead down to 5.
Well, this is a team that grinds you, really. Good ball movement. Virginia Tech tried to trap off the inbound so they don't get to Riddell quickly. Broncos just hanging around, but this guy, Jamon Gordon, Jacksonville, Florida native, has been lighting it up. Nice rhythm to his game. We talked about can get to the lane. Creates for himself. Little floater. There's a nice little pull-up jumper. Gives you the defensive look. Handles the ball in transition. Good solid guard. Part of a nice backcourt. 11 points. Pretty efficient. 7 shots.
Virginia Tech led by 11. It's now 5. And we're about to hit the 1 minute mark remaining in the first half. Western Michigan leading early 3-2. It's the only time all year so far that Virginia Tech has trailed in their first two games by an average of 48.5. Probendom, too long, drews the board.
We watched Western Michigan practice yesterday. Great intensity. All eyes on Coach Hawkins. A lot of belief in the system.
Andre Ricks, nope. Riddell, can he get threes back to back? Nope. But he and Drews collide going for the rebound, and Drews saves it from going backcourt. They can go for the last shot here. Shot clock turned off.
They ought to recognize seconds. That. I don't think they do.
Wright's traveled with 17.8.
Well, with the coaching staff at the far end of the court, they weren't able to get the attention of Riddell and Ricks, and that is a no-no. You always want the last shot of the half, particularly when you've crawled back into this game.
And instead, it's the Hokies who look for the last shot. Gordon guarded by Riddell. Tucker offering the screen. Throws it away, and the Broncos are going to get the last look after all.
Talked about this in the past. Right now, Dave, Western Michigan, if it's a clean pass in, Ricks or Riddell will get at least 3 or 4 dribbles towards the rim. Don't want to shoot it too quickly here. You got plenty of time.
They get Wright's back in place of Hershberger. 3.2. Here comes Riddell.
Now he had
from about 30 feet, he almost got.
He had one more dribble.
And he needed
listen.
It.
He didn't listen.
Needed every last inch, as it turned out. So Wright's after a slow start, 8 with 4 boards. Collins also 4 boards to go with his 3 points. Virginia Tech leads by as many as 11. It's 5, 34-29 at the half. To Scott Reese, Doug Gottlieb, Tom Brennan in the studio for a halftime report.
get some.
In the mid 80s. Busby.
Jacket?
I'll put mine on.
Sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
Look better on this one. You're watching ESPN2's college basketball coverage of Feast Week presented by Lowe's. The Old Spice Classic quarterfinal action from Orlando, Florida. Virginia Tech taking on Western Michigan. Due to time constraints, we move ahead in our action. You're watching ESPN2's college basketball coverage of Feast Week presented by Lowe's. Old Spice Classic quarterfinal action from the Milk House in Orlando, Florida, Virginia Tech against Western Michigan. We'll return after these messages. You're watching ESPN2's college basketball coverage of Feast Week presented by Lowe's. Old Spice Classic quarterfinal action from the Milk House in Orlando, Virginia Tech leading Western Michigan at the half 34-29. Hoop junkies, get ready. How can you get hundreds of extra college basketball games night after night? ESPN Full Court is how. To order, call DirecTV, the Dish Network, or your local cable operator. More action from Walt Disney World after this. You're watching ESPN2's college basketball coverage of Feast Week presented by Lowe's. Old Spice Classic quarterfinal action from the Milk House in Orlando, Florida as Montana takes on West Virginia. Due to time constraints, we move ahead in our action. You're watching ESPN2's college basketball coverage of Feast Week presented by Lowe's. Old Spice Classic quarterfinal action from the Milk House in Orlando, Florida. Montana against West Virginia. We'll return after these messages. Back in Orlando, Walt Disney World, the wide world of sports, Milk House, and 34-29, Virginia Tech leading Western Michigan. Dave Barnett back with Fran Fraschilla. 11-point lead was Virginia Tech's biggest. How did Western Michigan stay as close as they are?
You know, they grinded it out, Dave. They out-rebounded Virginia Tech. They also got themselves to the foul line. And unlike the first three games, they've made their free throws 10 of 12, so they've been pretty efficient. But they've not shot the ball well. They just seem to be a team that's tough, hard-nosed, and they're hanging around.
Well, the first half stats show pretty much across the board really bigger advantages for Virginia Tech than you would think looking at the scoreboard in just a 5-point game.
The one thing not on those stats, as I mentioned, those 10 of 12 from the foul line, very efficient.
Hokies 2-0, easy wins, about as easy as they can ever expect the rest of this year for Coppin State and Western Florida. But beginning with this tournament, the schedule becomes a little more like what they will face the rest of the year. Western Michigan 1-2, their victory over Detroit, 69-67. Carrying violation, they start the second half with a turnover. A.D. Vasayo, who comes off the bench but leads the Hokies in scoring, 20.5 first two games, just 1 3-pointer so far tonight.
Well, competition, I think, a large factor in that. Certainly, he's got a lot of attention tonight from Western Michigan, but he's also put himself in the bind with some poor decision making.
And a foul called by the officials on Fracalosi. Derek with his first of the game.
That's the beauty of having Vasayo come off the bench. You can regulate his minutes depending on how he's playing.
Robindom on the set play out of bounds, rights the board.
Interesting to see if Robindom stays in the lineup all year or if Virginia Tech goes small like they did last season.
Leading scorer in the first half, Michael Riddell, 9 points, including 6 of 6 from the free throw line, and he gets inside for two.
Well, he and Wrights combined for 17 of the 24 points in that half.
Coleman Collins. Best indication, friend, of what he's capable of is 4 meetings with Sheldon Williams of Duke. Good of players there was defensively in the country. He averaged about 16 points and 11 rebounds in those meetings against Williams and the Blue Devils.
Oh, and the memorable game last year where Virginia Tech lost in Cameron on a buzzer beater from half court. He was huge. 25 points, 8 rebounds in that contest with Duke.
Robindom called for his second foul.
But this is what Joe Wrights is about right here. He's not going to elevate over you. He's a physical player. Said earlier, he's not going to jump over the local phone book. But he gets himself to the line. He understands angles. He uses his body well.
Free throw shooting could improve. He is 4 for 7, 68% for the year coming in. For a pretty poor free throw shooting team. Western Michigan 62% of their first three. Wrights now with 9.
One of the things Virginia Tech has done in the past is they've used Collins as a decoy early. We'll go to him later as the game goes on.
Ron Washington just inside the paint. Now he's got 9. Jim Rat.
Yeah, exactly, because he had to play inside and spent a lot of time this summer working on that mid and long range jumper.
It is paying off. 15 points per game in their first two. Riddell maybe testing his heat. Not this time. Wrights out for Gary.
Nice shot fake.
And right back inside for Wrights, but they may wave this off. Offensive foul.
Mark Whitehead was the middle official there. He had a perfect angle. Keep your eye out. Great shot fake by Gary. Now he comes to the lane. You see Robindom establish himself on Tuesday. Obvious charge.
And that's 3 on Shantese Gary. Another whistle prior to the shot.
Well, we know Wrights can score. Riddell more of a point guard, but certainly a huge lift at the end of the half. The transfer from Cleveland State, recruited by Mike Garland, former Michigan State assistant. Now at SMU with Matt Doherty, doing a nice job for Matt Doherty down there. Inbounds.
Best inbounds play yet.
Mm-hmm.
As nobody guards Gordon. Jamon Gordon now with 13 points, leading all scorers.
Seth Greenberg is one of those guys that will draw X and O's on a napkin at 2 in the morning in Denny's. And he's got his brother Brad, who's got NBA X and O experience as well. And you've seen it pay off tonight on those inbounds plays.
Wrights. Big block by Washington, but it went out to Fracalosi. Now Riddell leaving it behind for Workman, who it's his first three-pointer, first points of the night, in fact.
That's why he's in the starting lineup as a freshman, young man from LaGrange, Indiana, Northern Indiana.
Another Bronco foul. This will be their fourth already.
Coming in tonight, Dave, 19 shots. He's attempted 16 from three. There's the block.
Fairly close to a goaltend, but I think the officials got it right.
That's one of those calls that I don't, you know, we get the benefit of the replay. A lot of those block, those goaltending calls are bang-bang plays. You see Mid-American Conference, watch out for Toledo, very good. Kent State, Akron is very good. Keith Dambrot's team. Justin Ingram of Toledo, really good shooter. Skip Mills from Ball State, among the Player of the Year candidates in the Mid-American Conference.
Washington launches the three-pointer, and Krobendam reading that one well off the back of the rim. Fracalosi checks out after picking up his third foul, and Dowdell call for carry.
See a lot of that early in the year, obviously, point of emphasis. The key will be, you know, will that be called a palming violation? Watch him now. He comes to see the ball comes through. That's close, because that ball usually has to come to a rest. It's almost like an interrupted dribble.
But if they're going to get the players used to the idea that they're going to call that, don't they have to call the borderline calls early?
I think they have to call the obvious ones early, and they got to call the obvious ones in January and February. You know, that's where I think, you know, my issue is with that particular call and others that they emphasize in November and December, that they need to be called in February as well.
We'll see. So far in the NBA as well, they're calling it early. Will they call it late is the question. McLemore, Martell misses the three.
Well, the freshman was a scorer in high school, but quick there.
Senior's missing the connection that time. Gordon's pass off Dowdell, who didn't expect it.
It's interesting, Dave, about the points of emphasis in terms of the officiating, because officials, then we come to March in the NCAA tournament, officials will not advance in the tournament if they don't make those obvious calls, the calls that are expected out of the palming violations.
Well, not shy, right back up. McLemore misses another three. And Washington tries to save it, fouled in the corner by Drews. We have a timeout, 15:49 to play, Hokies by five. Disney's Wide World of Sports here in Orlando, home to more than 180 events and over 30 sports each year, like the AAU National Championships, Atlanta Braves spring training, Pop Warner Super Bowl, Tampa Bay Buccaneers preseason training camp. And inside the Milk House, the inaugural Old Spice Classic. Virginia Tech leading almost throughout by as many as 11, by 5 at the moment, 40-35.
Tell you what, this is going to be a great venue. This first year of this tournament here at Wide World of Sports, and this thing will grow. You'll see ranked teams here in the future. And first year, the field is set. It was set in July, Dave, because the ruling that eliminates how many exempt tournaments you can be in every 4 years has been lifted.
Foul called by the officials on Drews. Disney Wide World of Sports. Built in 1997, 47 square miles. As we said, Buccaneers train here, Braves train here. 5,000 capacity Milk House. This is just perfect size facility for this event.
For this kind of feast week type tournament, you picture about 3,000 Kentucky fans in here someday?
Easily. Prabhendam drops in his first points. His parents frequented the U.S. living in the Netherlands. He was not unfamiliar with where he would end up going to school. In fact, it's not even his first trip to Disney World.
Very wise, worldly European.
Matchups earlier today, overtime win Arkansas over Southern Illinois and Marist over Minnesota.
Marist Jared Jordan with 10 assists. He led the country in assists last year. Very solid mid-major point guard.
A.D. Vasayo back in, and as usual takes him maybe 2.5 seconds to get his first shot up. But the Broncos just hanging around here. They refuse to let the Hokies get comfortable, and Andre Rick scores on the drive.
Well, you know, I mentioned blue collar earlier, scrappy. This is what we've seen really from the beginning. Even when shots weren't falling, they bang inside, they attack the rim, not afraid of the size. They'll get their shots blocked, but they keep coming at you.
Coleman Collins not looking real comfortable with that kind of range. And the biggest possession in a long while for the Broncos. Drews, three-pointer, knocks the bottom out. This is a two-point game.
Well, Rick's got all the way to the lane, sucked in five white shirts, but he knew where Drews was. Good kick out. Andre Ricks, young man, a sophomore from Detroit. He's played some competition. He's not a fear of anybody.
Derrick Drews, 10 for 13 on the year from three. Come on if you're feeling, alright. Come on if you're feeling, alright. Come on if you're feeling. Thank you. Bronco fans enjoying an 8-2 run over the last 3 minutes and 6 seconds, down by as many as 11 in the first half, but Derrick Drew's three-pointer has cut it to two. Steve Hawkins in his fourth year, until last year, won 20 every season, made the NCAA tournament at 04, the NIT last year, and the NCAA's lost to Vanderbilt here in Orlando.
Well, in the media guide, Western Michigan's media guide, it says the one thing he looks for as a recruit is toughness, and that's what this team is, a very scrappy team.
Proving it here in the second half.
Another steal.
And after coughing it up, the Hokies compound it with the foul. Jamon Gordon's second and the team's second.
Dave, you said earlier about this team being a Mac-like team. You look at guys, and Riddell is a perfect example. These guys weren't recruited by Michigan State and Purdue. They play with a chip on their shoulder. Every time they get the opportunity, you see Riddell with the assist. Every time they get the opportunity to take on a team from a league like the ACC, Mac teams come to play, like this guy, Ricks.
Andre Ricks ties it at 42.
Detroit Pershing High School, home of Spencer Haywood. Guy like Ricks has played against all the best in the summertime. Down at St. Cecilia's in Detroit. These guys play with no fear.
First tie since 5-all. Broncos led 3-2, that was it. And the Hokies fumble it away again. Intended inside for Collins.
You know, this is sort of near and dear to my heart because I spent 6 years in the MAC at Ohio U, so I've seen this before. These, you know, you look at Toledo and Akron, Kent State. It's a very competitive league.
If they get a shot at an ACC team, you know the level of effort you're going to get. Drews is 3-for-3 on threes. And the Broncos lead by 3.
He went 4-for-4 against Pitt early in the year in the Maggie Dixon Classic. Young man from Northern Indiana. We talked about, he's only an hour from Kalamazoo.
Sophomore from Elkhart. A.D. Vasayo and Virginia Tech unable to answer. Dowdell can't get the follow. One more try and he's fouled. Poor little Xavier Dowdell refusing to take no for an answer.
You're looking at a guy 6'3", pounding the boards. Look at the rhythm and the smoothness of that shot. That looks like Jimmy Chitwood. Look at that. I saw that. Well, 20 years ago now, the movie Hoosiers, Jimmy Chitwood.
Dowdell fouled by Martell McLemore. That is 17 fouls, and here comes a line change. 5 new Broncos all in at once. Right?
The starters,
Riddell,
right?
Yep, Fracaldosi, Workman.
Hey. Workman didn't start. He did start today.
Yeah. What a job by that group of five off the bench.
Dean Smith used to have that blue team that came in.
45-43. Western Michigan controlling things here. First 8 minutes of the second half.
Early in the game, Dave, we talked about the depth of both teams.
Coleman Collins picks up his third out front, team's third. Yeah, and you don't think maybe of a team that was 14-17 last year, Western Michigan, without any seniors this year as being particularly deep, but they are. And especially with David Kuhl available, coming back off his hamstring. Michigan Mr. Basketball Award winner. Freshman from Grand Rapids, here's Sean T. Scary, fouled before his shot.
Well, they play fearlessly, but really when you think about it, the area that Steve Hawkins recruits from, you talk about Detroit, Chicago, and then Northern Indiana. The thing about those Northern Indiana kids, they're all so well coached in high school.
And the Big Ten can't sign them all.
That's right. And a guy like Wrights, if he were 2 inches bigger, or this guy, if he was 2 inches bigger, little Drew Knight's a limitation.
Michael Riddell puts him up by 5.
Former All-State player in Michigan. Look at the D.
Virginia Tech just searching for one successful play here in the second half. Nothing's worked. Dowdell gets the best look they've had. He's got 9.
Dowdell very good in the mid-range. Because of his size, he's able to bull his way to that 10-foot area.
Jaquite off the ball, call for his second, team's fifth. Michael Riddell with 14, leading the Western Michigan upset bid. Tonight's game presented in high definition on ESPN2 HD. Brought to you by Olivia in Western Michigan, surprising Virginia Tech here in the second half after trailing by as many as 11 in the first half. And awaiting game two tonight, Wayne Tinkle and the Montana Grizzlies. They will take on West Virginia about half hour or so after the conclusion of this game.
Another one of those bracket busters that are in this tournament. Montana with a big win over Nevada, first round NCAAs a year ago.
Western Michigan taking it to the Hokies time after time here in the second half, and Shauntese Gary with a nice pin.
Only a sophomore, started as a freshman. Outstanding slasher to the basket.
It's now an 18-5 Bronco run over the last 6 minutes, including 4 3-pointers. Chris Tucker, look what I found, shot but no bucket. And Virginia Tech continues, first of all, Fran, have a hard time getting open looks. When they get them, they're not knocking them down.
And Western Michigan attacking both boards.
Back to the basket, Joe Wright with 11.
I don't think his feet ever left the ground. That's how low he jumps, but it doesn't matter.
Valdell's three, batted around, controlled by Garrett.
Now they've got Virginia Tech now out of sorts. Quick shots, not getting anything in the lane tonight. That's been a big factor. Collins has been quiet.
And in the first 10 minutes of the second half, it's 23-11 Western Michigan. Down at the half, 34-29. Shot clock under 10, Riddell out front.
Uh-oh.
Behind the bat, bounce for Workman, about 28 feet out with the shot clock winding down. And Wright's colliding with Munson as that one goes out. Virginia Tech back on their heels, not looking confident at all. Not that they should have a reason to feel confident this half.
Now Western Michigan with a slow start to this game. But even when they were playing poorly, they were grinding you, banging both boards. Interestingly now, they've gone inside. Gary and has attacked the rim. Wrights has gotten it inside, and yet they've knocked down 4 of 6 this half from behind the arc. So a lot of variety in that Bronco offense.
Rakolosi checks out.
Drews is in. 3 for 3 on three-pointers for Derrick Drews. And the officials call contact inside on him. That's going to be his third and 8th on the team.
Well, good strategy right there. If you can't stop him on the offensive end, then try to get him in foul trouble and get him out of the ball game.
Derrick Drews, sophomore from Elkhart, Indiana, will now have to watch himself on the defensive end. Sean T. Scary also with 3. And for Virginia Tech, it's Deron Washington on the line, hitting the front end.
You really think about it, Dave. A guy shooting that well on the offensive end, if you can't get him in foul trouble, at least make him defend on the defensive end, try to tire him out. That time, the double whammy, because he did commit that third foul.
Washington gets them both. Needed points for the Hokies.
We haven't seen the pressure since early in the game. And it's the first time we've seen, it looks like, a little one now, man-to-man.
Why do you think they backed off of it?
I think because of how easily Western Michigan attacked it in the first half, even though they didn't get those easy opportunities. They came up empty. They handled the ball well.
Wright's turning in on Krabendam. And Robert Krabendam picks up his third.
Tell you what Wright's did. Very intelligent right there. He saw the double team come from the middle, so he took the ball away from the double team, attacked Krabendam. This time now, Virginia Tech adjusting a little bit. Watch the double come right there. So Wright takes it away from the double and still manages to get himself to the foul line. And that happens, Dave, because Wright gets double teamed all season in the MAC conference. So he's used to where the defensive pressure is coming from. So he just took it away from the flow of the defense.
Andre Ricks in for Riddell. Wright hits both ends. 13 points for Joe Wright, 7 of 10 from the free throw line. And what throws to 7. Washington missed everything. Broncos look like they're going to come up with a loose ball. All of a sudden, from nowhere, Jamon Gordon scores the layup. He's got 15. Okay.
Gaudel and Gordon, junkyard dogs, when they're not getting it going in terms of knocking down shots, both physical enough to get you some rebounds inside. These guys would be small forwards in the Mid-American Conference.
Maybe power forwards.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty powerfully built, 6'3".
Yep. So many mid-major teams have those undersized guys like Wrights that are very effective. They get overlooked by the high majors.
Andre Ricks with a 3.
Talk about confidence. Gotta love a guy who plays with a smile on his face. Watch Ricks now, kind of freezes the defender. He's got a 6'9 Coleman. Little step back through the legs. Ball looked like it was going in as the minute he left his hands.
Andre Ricks from a fighting family.
Mm-hmm.
Father Danny Paul, a boxer. His god uncle is Thomas Hitman Hearns.
And you want to know why he plays fearlessly? You think he's worried about a basketball game? You think he's worried about Virginia Tech when he's got to deal with his god uncle?
They're checking to see if this is a 2 or a 3. Where were the feet? That right foot might have been on.
Mm-hmm. That's a tough angle from there, but our crack production crew will probably give him a couple different looks. Let's see here. Up, oh, that's going to be 2.
I think that's a 2.
That's why you can go to the monitor. Mark Whitehead, Terry Moore, 2 veteran officials. Sometimes you can't blame Ricks. He's just trying to shoot the ball over a 6'9 guy. I used to hate my guys who shot it right in that 18-foot area. You should tell him you back up a foot, you get 3 points instead of 2.
Might as well. So it is a 2. It is properly corrected. 56-49, Western Michigan.
I still didn't wipe the smile off of Ricks's face.
He doesn't play well. You got to face his god uncle. Turnaround shot, Gordon, just about the only consistent offense the Hokies have.
Well, particularly inside, if Collins can't get him done inside, they've gone into Gordon. Of course, he's gotten a couple of offensive rebounds as well.
Under the 8-minute mark. 1-2 Western Michigan trying for a signature win over ACC team Andrew Hershberger, and everybody for Western Michigan now, friends, shooting with confidence.
Mm-hmm. Let's hope he's okay. Hershberger went down hard after scoring.
And the call will go on Andre Hicks. It'll be his third. Team's ninth. All Broncos here in the second half of this quarterfinal in the Old Spice Classic in Orlando.
ESPN2's exclusive presentation of college basketball is brought to you by Old Spice Deep Cleansing Body Wash. Nothing cleans deeper.
Well, if any school should like its chances on Thanksgiving Day, you think it'd be the team sometimes known as the Gobblers, Virginia Tech Hokies. They're being gobbled up by this Western Michigan shooting display in the second half.
Very smart basketball team coached by Steve Hawkins. Keep your eye now on this play. Watch this, Dave. Pick play in football. You know that wide receiver pick play. And we'll have it soon.
Just building the anticipation.
Yeah. Yep. We'll go inside the play. It'll take a little longer, but watch Workman number three. He catches the ball, and on the reversal to Gary, we're going to freeze it right here. Watch how Workman cuts in front of Gary. There's no contact, so it's not a moving screen, but just enough to create that space for Gary to get by Dowdell and get to the rim. Well done, well executed. That happens when a big man is involved with a guard, because big man shows, but he's not quick enough to stay in front of Shantice Gary.
Ron Washington. Very short on the first and two. Western Michigan had 29 points at the half. They already have 29 here in the second half. They're shooting 65%, 11 out of 17 since intermission.
And they've done it from inside and out. Starting to sizzle from the perimeter, also have attacked the rim with success.
And hitting the free throws, which they had not done in the first three games. Ricks,
wow,
step on Gordon, crosses over. What a finish by Andre Ricks.
What's impressive right there is he just took an all-ACC defensive guard from last year.
Washington answers. Layup for layup. Ricks, 8 of his 10 points here in the second half.
So now you got Washington on Ricks.
That says something about what Virginia Tech thinks of Andre Ricks at 5'9", 155.
Well, just a switch there, so they've got Gordon back on him.
Washington leaving Gary and chasing the ball.
Now he's going to take Dowdell.
And Ricks, rebound by Rice, blocked from behind by Lewis Witcher. And it's Washington in transition for Dowdell on the reverse finish.
Great pass by Washington. He would have charged had he taken it to the rim. Good feed.
last couple of possessions, the best the Hokies have looked this half, and they cut the lead to 4, and Steve Hawkins wants timeout.
Now they've turned up the defensive intensity. Watt shot led to the open court runout. Watch Ricks right here. He fakes like he's going to use the screen, so Dowdell jumps to the screen, and Ricks says so long. A lot of times when you play the pick and roll out high, you want to force that man to the screen because that's where your help is. So many defenders cheat towards that screen, and then they get blown by, a la Andre Ricks.
Uncle Hitman would be proud.
Very proud.
God, Rick Uncle feet. Hitman. Feast Week presented by Lowe's continues on Saturday night, 11 Eastern, with a matchup on ESPN2 of number 1 Florida and number 12 Kansas. Early test for the defending national champion Gators as part of the Las Vegas Invitational.
Now that outstanding freshman for Kansas, Darrell Arthur, will have his hands full with Horford and Noah in the front line of Billy Donovan.
After a first half where Steve Hawkins Broncos search for anything consistently offensively, they're 60% here in the second half. They turn it over here on an offensive foul against Fracalosi, and that is his 4th.
Well, Washington got his chin right up on Fracalosi and took the blow. Keep your eye on that. See the good ball pressure. Fracalosi trying to create space. A little acting job, but there was contact.
Hokies in the double bonus rest of the way. Driving baseline for the jam is Gordon with 19.
Oh, that's Seth Greenberg's post-up game right now. Go inside to Gordon at 6'2", 6'3".
Suddenly the lead is 2. Fracalosi, 3-pointer halfway down, and Collins fumbles it out of bounds.
And Dave, the reason he was so wide open is Virginia Tech has started to double team right inside. That left Fracalosi open, but here's the clear out isolation for Gordon, and is able to step through the defender and get to the rim. So Gordon has done it a lot of different ways offensively tonight with no post offense out of Collins.
He's part of a 6-0 Virginia Tech run now.
Keep your eye now when Wrights gets it, if Virginia Tech continues to double, because if he handles it smoothly, Western Michigan will get an open shot.
Riddell back in for Ricks.
If you're a young player at home, you are a good post scorer if you command a double team. They don't double team you, they don't respect your offense.
Collins fronting Wrights. So Riddell has to go into the corner for Hershberger.
There's the double. Whoa!
Hard landing as Vasayo comes down on Wrights.
The Red Bull got him.
Got him good. This will be 3 on Vasayo.
You see now, watch the double come. Now Wrights immediately looks to the weak side of the floor, but before he can make the play out of that double, Vasayo with a tackle that Frank Beamer would be proud of.
Broncos in the bonus now. Here's Wrights, 13-8.
This is where you pick your poison if you're Seth Greenberg, because if you don't double Wrights, he's going to get to the foul line. If you choose to double it, he makes the play out of the double team. Now you're 4-on-3. An advantage to the offense.
Tonight he's making his free throws. 8-for-11. 9-out-of-12, and he's hit 5 straight. As they get Donald Lawson, freshman 6'9 center out of Chicago, in.
A man from a very good Catholic high school, Leo.
2-time Chicago Catholic League Defensive Player of the Year. 3-pointer. Dowdell, just his 5th 3 of the year so far, but the Hokies are within 1 at the 5-minute mark.
You can see the veteran leadership right now of Dowdell and Gordon taking over this game on the offensive end for Seth Greenberg.
He's continuing to double the ball. Riddell tries to beat Collins inside, and Gordon will be called for his 3rd, team's 8th.
And watch Dowdell. He's got the step back move down to a science. Takes the ball in, puts it through his legs, creates space, which good shooters do. Need a little bit of separation from the defense to shoot your jumper in rhythm.
just me, or is that shot becoming a lot more popular as Steve Nash has won MVP?
You know, it's a great point, Dave. It's a great shot for smaller guards. Now, 6'2", you say he's not that, you know, 6'2", 6'3", but when you're being guarded by players at his level, that step-back move that Nash has perfected creates space.
Second end goes for Riddell, 63-61 Broncos. Riddell just about doubling his average of 8 coming in. Basayo, not there for 3. Rebound tipped over to Riddell. This is a 4-on-1 Bronco break. No look pass. Drews finally missing a 3. He had hit his first 3 from out there.
Well, great contest that time by Dowdell to get back into play.
And Dowdell with the finish high off the glass.
Talk about Steve Nash. How about the floater off the glass? A good shot for a guard to have. Instead of taking it all the way to the rim, release it early before the shot blockers can get to it.
And Xavier Dowdell from here in Florida, from Pahokee, Florida, ties it at 63. With no under 4 minutes.
Yep, senior guard.
Tip in from nowhere. Lawson, first points as a Bronco.
That's an energy basket, Dave, because he's not an offensive player.
Those are the shots they want him looking for. Mm-hmm. And he can hardly have picked a better time to score his first 2 as a collegian. 3:35 remaining. Western Michigan from as many as 11 back in the first half, coming right at the Hokies, leading by as many as 8 here in the second. Well, if you come to Disney World, the MGM Studios, you gotta go on the Rock and Roller Coaster starring Aerosmith. You'll go 0 to 60 in 2.8 seconds. And there's some twists and turns in there. And as you're waiting in line, I think it's holograms of Aerosmith in the studio.
You have to listen to the music, I guess.
You get to listen to
okay, I'm sorry. Yes. Didn't mean to offend you.
And then Steven Tyler says, let's go to the forum. And then you sit down and you take off and you go 0 to 60 in 2.8. And the whole thing's over in what seems like about 10 seconds, but it's worth it.
Mm-hmm. Well, a lot of us last night, after a great dinner, Thanksgiving dinner, a lot of us went on Tower of Terror.
Ron Washington missing the front end. Tough luck in a 14-16 year, 16 losses by an average margin of just 5.5 points. 8 of their 10 in the ACC were by 4 points. or less, and Sean Dockery's 40-footer won it for Duke, 77-75. Doesn't get much tougher.
Yep, and the good news, bad news for Seth Greenberg is these veteran guards have been in a lot of close games. That should pay dividends in this kind of situation, hopefully for Hokie fans.
Hokies put Washington out on Drews. Is it three threes? In fact, they pick up everywhere in terms of the defensive intensity. Shot clock under 10. Riddell spotting an opening. Shaunte Scary rejected by Gordon, who may be the top defensive guard, Brad, in the ACC.
Excellent pressure that time.
Fasayo missing from the corner.
Well, Fasayo is one of those guys that keeps both teams in the game. I'm sure that's not the quick shot that Seth Greenberg wanted, but he's a guy that heats up, so sometimes you live with that.
2:40 to play. Broncos by one. Workman took his eyes off of it. Dowdell came down on the sideline. Feast Week presented by Lowe's, continuing tomorrow night for college hoops on ESPN and ESPN2. Two games from the Dick's Sporting News NIT season tip-off, 4:30 Eastern on ESPN, the consolation matchup between number 21 Tennessee and number 2 North Carolina. And then at 7 Eastern, ESPN2 has the championship game, the surprising matchup of Butler and Gonzaga.
The Horizon League and the West Coast Conference.
Broncos called time here. Virginia Tech, if you look back through their athletic history, most of the highlights have happened on the football field since Frank Beamer became the head coach. But back in 1973, on the basketball court, they won the NIT.
Puts the ball in play to Bobby Stevens. Hawked by Clay. 8 seconds. 6 seconds. Bobby Stevens shoots. No good. The rebound to Stevens. He'll throw something off at the buzzer. There it is. Virginia Tech wins the NIT at the final buzzer with a shot by Bobby Stevens. Unbelievable.
Of course they did. The opponent was coached by Digger Phelps. They didn't have the last second play down. Actually, that came off a tip ball. Hard luck for the Irish.
Workman rejected by Gordon. He's got two blocks in a row from the same spot on the court.
Last 2 minutes, Virginia Tech's defensive intensity has turned up a sense of urgency now that we didn't see early in the second half when Western Michigan took that lead.
Hershberger in for Workman. That Virginia Tech team, led by a future longtime pro and head coach in the NBA, Alan Bristow.
Alan Bristow. Coach, the team was coached by Don DeVoe, who, of course, went on to success not only at Tech, but at Wyoming, Tennessee, Navy.
And it was a bigger deal to win the NIT back then.
That's right.
The NCAA field was nowhere near as big, about half the size. That was the field of 32, if I remember.
And 16 teams went to the NIT, and they all would have been in the tournament today.
Top shot, lefty scoop, 17 points. Joe Wright's Broncos back up by 3 at the 2-minute mark.
Very few righties go as well to their left as Wright's does.
Nice spin move and finish by Washington.
Now this is now a possession game.
Riddell with an ill-advised pass that time. There was really no alley to get it to Wright.
And that was my point. In a game like this now, there's going to be about 8 possessions that decide this game. 4 on offense, 4 on defense for each team. There, Western Michigan threw one away. Just wasted a possession.
17th turnover. Hokies went through a long spell of no offensive confidence, but they've come through it. Now they'll shoot for the lead. 90 seconds. Dowdell losing the footing, but not the ball. Got it to Washington. And a timeout call before the shot.
And I think what Seth Greenberg did is when his player fell down, he signaled quickly to Mark Whitehead to take the timeout because the coach can do that from the sideline. He did not want a traveling violation.
But I've been out of peace. Joe Wright, slow start, great finish.
Well, slow start. He's a slow player in terms of, he does not wow you with athleticism, but very crafty around the rim. You want to know why this guy might be the MAC player of the year this year? Keep your eye on him because very efficient inside, does a good job on the glass, makes his free throws today. Has got a great left hand for a right-handed player. Again, one of those guys we talked about that maybe was an inch or two too small for the Big Ten. Maybe not athletic enough, but a very solid player. One of those guys that bust brackets in March.
17 seconds on the shot clock, a minute 26 in the game. Inbounds to Vasayo, puts it up off balance and got it. First points of the half, five for the game. But Hokies leading scorer coming in, Virginia Tech with its first lead since 42-40, 13 minutes to go.
And that's why Vasayo stayed out there after a couple of tough shots. Oh, got a hook inside on Collins, didn't see it.
Inside a minute now, Broncos have led most of this half. Now down one, Riddell steps in, hits the deck hard, and will shoot two with 52 seconds.
Dave, Riddell has a great knack of taking his body to the defense. So that time he was tripped, but he really understands how to get to the lane. Just gets in there, kind of see the little body, the little shoulder shrug. He takes his body to the defense and he puts the defender at a disadvantage and forces the official to make the call.
Michael Riddell, 7 of 8 at the free throw line tonight. 15 points for the sophomore transfer from Cleveland State. Ties it at 68.
Steve Hawkins has a bunch of guys that mentioned earlier, Detroit, Michigan, Northern Indiana, Chicago. Tough group.
No doubt on either shot by Riddell and a fifth lead change. Broncos 69-68. Next to last timeout called here by Seth Greenberg.
Your two most consistent offensive players for Seth Greenberg have been the two guards. Obviously, Vasayo can heat it up, but Gordon and Dowdell have carried this team. They've scored inside and out, but Jamon Gordon, four-year starter. Of course, one of those years was in the Big East as a freshman, three in the ACC. Honorable mention, all ACC. Can get to the rim, can shoot the deep three. There's a good example right there of the isolation. And that's what I think you'll see right now, Dave. I doubt seriously Western Michigan will change the zone. They're a gritty man-to-man team. Seth Greenberg's gonna take another timeout, which he is allowed to do.
So he just didn't get it all in on one timeout.
That's right, took a second 30. And now it's a full, because they're sitting down.
46.6 seconds. Feast Week presented by Lowe's, continuing Saturday night, 11 Eastern from the Las Vegas Invitational. It's going to match up, as we'll see in these first few weeks of the college basketball season, as number one defending national champion Florida takes on 12th ranked Kansas. That is 11 Eastern Saturday night from Las Vegas on ESPN2.
Underrated matchup in that contest will be Russell Robinson, one of the best defensive point guards in the country, and a guy that has already led his team to a national championship, Torian Green, who's just, you hate to say he's under the radar because he's part of a national championship team. But